the entire, we had people who would come over and they would basically, we had fire engines come over and they'd water the property down because they'd come to the party. They'd bring their own beer, their own stuff, and would bring a big celebration. And there were so many people that drank so much and ate so much, you wonder why nobody ever got hurt. The worst that we ever had was people stepping on the sparklers. I mean, they tell people, they have cans, throw the sparklers in the cans with the water. So what would happen? The guests, the kids never screwed up. The adults would walk around without their shoes on, and guess what? They'd throw their sparkler down and then they'd step on the thing. And none of them could ever say anything. I do remember my uncle going back home, and he's burned his feet on the sparklers, and he'd been walking around all that time on burnt feet because the sparklers were always the first to go.
Yeah.
So, you know, we'd run through them quickly, but he'd get burnt, you know, so he wouldn't tell anybody. It wasn't the fact he was a Marine, it's because he told his kids, you know, I don't want you walking in your bare foot out there because people throw those sparklers. They were his sparklers. He stepped on his own sparklers. Mm-hmm. Yeah. And you'd think that next year he learned? Mm-hmm. Barefooted again. Mm-hmm. But then, you know, so we are very dumb, thick-headed Germans and Irish. Yeah. But,
Your grandma was into stuff like that, too.
My grandmother was a member of the Irish Republican Army.
See? He grew up around it.
My grandfather was a Prussian. A Prussian fencing master. Mm-hmm. You know, so Then my father was a tank officer, you know, when the first tanks started coming in before World War II. So, and he made boom in movies. I used to be in lots of war things. I could go boom and stuff. I loved to play cow. I loved to play, you know, soldier because I got to shoot things. Mm-hmm. So, I learned a salute of one gun for each state in the United States called a salute to the states is fired on Independence Day. By any capable military base, that's the one. In 2009, New York City, the largest fireworks display in the country with over 22 tons of polytechnicals exploded. I know, like Michigan, San Diego is listed as one of the top ones, and now they've been shut down.
Are you serious?
And now they've been shut down by Obama. So
they had one of the largest fireworks displays, San Diego did?
Yeah.
Oh, I didn't know that.
Yeah, they said they're gonna
Don't plan on them shutting it down in Chicago.
No. Don't count on shutting it down in Washington, D.C. either, because
Washington, D.C. has a great one.
No, here's a good one. The same piss ants that are trying to shut everything down hold their own individual family fireworks displays and parties, mm-hmm. and they go to the Capitol Mall to see the fireworks display, and they're the one when the fireworks go, ooh. Oh, they got their little grandkids on them, and they're pointing, ooh, but they're saying, hey, San Diego, hey, New York City, hey, Chicago. No more of that because it's bad, and they're going, ooh.
Yeah, forget the Grinch that stole Christmas. It's the EPA that stole the 4th of July.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Basically, we got during the annual Windsor Detroit International Freedom Festival, Detroit, Michigan holds one of the world's largest fireworks displays.
I didn't know that.
Yeah. Like I said, my grandfather, my mother's father, was a member of the Mummers, and he would go to the Philadelphia and the Detroit thing in his big costume. They play. You know, they play banjos and stuff, and they strut, you know, so they're doing all of this, you know. They're doing this, strutting, for miles down the road. They're doing dance moves and stuff, and everybody, you know, it's just a big deal. So I got to go see that stuff because my mother got to, you know, say, well, that's a good time, you know, good place to money. You realize how much alcohol was going on in those places. You think those guys didn't drink before they went out and walked? You think those guys? That's why they were doing a lot of their really classy moves, you know, with the stuff was because they were loose. And then they got looser after. Mummers I don't think exist anymore. Then they got looser after. What it was, it got too cost expensive to do this stuff, so.
Well, I'm excited about this 4th of July. In fact, I'm going to plan more this year.
Yeah.
Part of it is people celebrate the 4th of July, especially in larger, because people celebrate the 4th of July in larger communities because they have different special many days.
See, we have the opportunity to go over to Disney on the 3rd of July, which means we stayed up, we could keep the 4th.
Oh,
free.
We could.
Yeah. We can go over
the
3rd on the 3rd.
The 3rd of July is Sunday.
Sunday. We can go over on a Sunday and watch the stuff there because I like the fireworks. I have no means of. basically I can't record the bloody stuff. So I can't say, I like to watch all of the fireworks, so I can't say, I like to watch all of the displays on TV, I can't.
God bless America, land that we love.
You know, I love that too. So, people, here's one. People don't understand. Who do you think was there? This is going to be a
hit. And where?
What's her name? The woman that basically is famous for singing God Bless America, Kate. Mr. Rogers was the director and floor manager of her television show when she first sang that.
Really?
Fred Rogers, folks.
Mr. Rogers' Neighborhood.
And he basically was there when she basically did that thing on television to set the whole country ablaze. You know, that just on the 4th of July, that was, you know, she'd been doing it on radio, but basically she'd been doing radio sort of become passe by the late 1940s, and people were paying more attention to TV. So when she came out and did, you know, she was a big woman, and that was a piece of history. Fred Rogers.
That's cool.
There. Yeah.
That's really cool.
While the official observance always falls on the 4th of July, participation levels may vary according to which day of the week the 4th falls on. If the holiday falls in the middle of the week, some fireworks displays and celebrations may take. A few years ago, my family, my little one, we went to Disney World to see the 4th of July in Disney World. Mm-hmm. So, which was sort of a big deal. I mean, we were there for days. We were watching all the celebrations in all of the different spots, all the different lands. We were, you know, boom, 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 and you sit there. We actually got to watch it from the monorail.
Really?
One night, so. But their fourth celebration went on for like 5 days or something. But it was a neat thing, so it's the advantage of being in the business that I'm in and the family that I had, that I was able to go see stuff. I mean, I've seen 4th of July celebrations. I was able to go see stuff. I mean, I've seen 4th of July. They would...
Really? I didn't know they celebrated outside this country.
I've been in Hawaii.
Well, that's considered in this country.
And I've been in Japan when they celebrated it, which got the Japanese pissed off because the ships would go out and boom, and you see the ship rolling to a side.
Oh, that's right, because they all have American bases.
Yeah, I actually know. I know jet pilots. I actually know tracers are really neat to look at when you see them. You know, and what happens is if you're a jet fighter pilot, you know that every so many bullets in the belt feed is a tracer, so you can see where they're going. But they would replace everything with tracers, so you could just see that. And I've seen the military planes on 4th of July celebrations in this country. You know, basically, flying in formation, firing all at once. So I've seen World War II planes doing all of their fancy stuff. I've seen bombings doing all of their fancy stuff. I've seen runs with the stuff. It's neat to see that stuff. I mean, it's just the advantage of being old because
enjoy your fireworks.
Because we'll put it this way, this is one of the things where I do take sides. If this administration continues in power, you will see all of this stuff vanish, all of it. So that was the end of our thing on the 4th. This was the thing is that if you want to celebrate the 4th of July, you're going to have to tell your congressman to lay off. Mm-hmm. Tell your congressman to lay off. Mm-hmm. This is your allegiance to Joseph Stalin or Vladimir Lenin
or whoever.
This is the 4th Lenin
or whoever.
This is the 4th of July.
Whoever.
This is the 4th of July. Just lay the hell off. What do you think would happen if you screwed with May Day in the Soviet Union? What do you think if they screw with Chinese New Year in China? Yeah, what about Bastille Day in France? You don't think that there you wouldn't have a problem? So They think they can do it in this country. They can legislate things out of existence that they don't believe in. They don't believe in what the force stands for. So you basically shut it down for the good of the people. Well, I go back long enough to understand that Broadway was dying. It was totally dying. Nobody, I mean, people, they didn't want, you know, all of these things, you know, that people basically didn't like the crap that came out of the 60s. So all of a sudden, somebody brought a little song, brought a little show to Broadway called Fiddler on the Roof. And it was all about tradition. Mm-hmm. When you mess with people's tradition, it's like there's a basic rule of thumb. It has to do with the same thing with tradition. It's got to do when the myth becomes fact, print the myth. Mm-hmm. People don't want things changed. They'll fight you tooth and nail over taking their traditions away from them. So you can do whatever you want as long as you don't step on a person's tradition. And the 4th of July is a tradition in this country. Mm-hmm. It may be held on the wrong day, and it may be held for the wrong reason, but it is a tradition. It's a tradition. It's over 200 days.
It is. It's a tradition here in the United States, and, you know, be vocal about this one.
You have to be. If you don't, you've got to stand for something. I mean, they burn the American flag. You know, they use the American flag to leap on. They use it for wiping up after dogs. But the problem is the 4th is still everybody's tradition. Even the people in our country that hate. Like I said, we have a Congress in the country that hate States on the flag if they had the opportunity. They would sit there and watch with their grandchildren. Like I said, it took a Frenchman to say this. If you take the rights away from the majority, the rights of the minority are soon to follow. So if you're standing up for minority rights and you take the other rights away, guess what's going to happen? There'll be no 4th of July if unfortunately the people leading our country have their way. Mm-hmm. So you've got to stand up for it. You want a 4th? You're losing it in San Diego right now. San Diego is the first.
It's real. It is. It's very, very tough.
And New York City is considerably more liberal than San Diego, so you can guess that it's going to go very quickly.
Well, in New York, I mean, that's one of their, like, what, New Year's Eve, the 4th of July? I mean, those are major events for the city.
They bring in tons of money, but the problem, so does the 4th of July thing in San Diego, because it's also like fleet time. Yep, so I guess until next time, this is Old Camp.
And this is Not a Spring Chicken. We're here yesterday, today, and tomorrow. For more information, you can always go to
www.montybobos.net on the internet.
And wherever you're watching, subscribe to us, follow our daily newscast in 3D. And remember, it's the 4th of July. Celebrate it, and thank you once again for over 40 million links on the internet.